Former influencer Lucy Malloy is being exposed for her incredibly racist past, and it seems following the well-deserved amount of backlash she received, she's actually deleted her Instagram account with 200,000 followers. Now, I say former influencer because when I tell you guys about her past, well, I don't know what brand will ever want to work with her again. But then again, as we know, people tend to forgive and forget, which truthfully, I'm all about, but it varies from situation to situation. As you guys can tell, I'm not the most forgiving when it comes to this stuff, but maybe you guys will have a different point of view. What's going on, guys? Welcome to Inform Overload. I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and today we got quite an interesting story. Some posts from about 9 or 10 years ago depict Lucy Malloy of Perth to be a supporter of a specific group of people that controlled Germany during World War II. Hopefully you guys get what I mean. You know, YouTube can be a little weird with certain words, but either way, make sure to stick around until the end of this one for some comments, and let's jump right into it. So it seems Lucy has been able to build herself quite a following, mostly just posting photos of herself. I'm gonna take a shot in the dark and say the appeal to her followers were the tattoos, but now that her racist past has come to light, well, she's gone ahead and actually deleted her account altogether. Following all the backlash, Lucy's husband, Dan, also deleted his Instagram account, but prior to doing so, he let followers know he'd be stepping down from his position as a tattoo artist and co-owner at Golden Panther Tattoo, where he previously worked. It seems Twitter user Abby_182_ was the first to expose Malloy, tweeting out, I quote, "Pay attention to who you follow. IG model Lucy Malloy is hiding and deleting comments about her racist past and refusing discussion by turning off comments on her apology. I've been blocked for calling it out, so I thought Twitter might be able to do something." Way to be Abby, because Twitter did do something. Accompanying the post with these four photos showing old Facebook posts of Malloy clearly showing her allegiance to the political party responsible for a genocide. At one point, she even praised the dictator who was in charge of an occupied Germany. In another post, which has since been deleted, she apparently praised the same man for killing, I quote, "as many humans as he did before he died." An apology would be published, but it seems no one really fell for it. Her apology claims the Facebook posts have since been deleted after someone took screenshots and shared them calling her racist. It goes on to read, I quote, "I am not racist and never have been. I didn't understand how serious what I was posting at the time was. I'd like to apologize for what I wrote. I have also sent a private message to the account posting the screenshots, apologizing and explaining myself." Now, as you can imagine, people were kind of like, you can't get exposed for having such a deeply rooted racist past and just apologize and be like, "Sorry guys, that was the old me, I'm different now." So after she received backlash for not being transparent at all regarding the situation, she posted a much longer notes app apology. She claims reading back the comments she wrote when she was 16 made her feel sick. I quote, "In 2011, a small wave of Nazi ideology swept through my hometown, hardcore seen like a virus. A group of much older skinheads were grooming kids towards white supremacy, and I was one of the few who were stupid, vulnerable, and insecure about their identity enough that it caught on." She goes on to explain that, I quote, "The furthest this went was wearing boots and suspenders to shows and making shocking comments on MySpace and Facebook." After that, she claims in her apology that she was called out by the people on the seriousness of what she was saying, which led to her and her friends to stop saying them. Over a period of time, they would change their ideologies, which took some memorable discussions and healing, as she puts it. Following her point, she goes on to say that over the past 9 years, she's watched everyone grow up to become politically conscious and compassionate adults. That kids aren't born into hate but taught it, and denies she had any Nazi paraphernalia, such as a flag, even though she claimed she previously did. Finishing it off, she wrote, I quote, "There is no such thing as trivial racism," and that she, I quote, "can see that my apology did not address the hurt that I have caused or make any amends. I want to learn and be able to look back in 10 years and be more proud of the ally I became than the ignorant racist I was. I'm deeply sorry." Now, there appears to be some holes in this apology as well, with people from the hardcore scene explaining not only did they never see anyone like Malloy at the shows, but they wouldn't have been welcomed regardless. Twitter user HillaryB89 tweeted, I quote, "Lucy Malloy forgets a lot of us were all in the scene, for me anyways, from 2008 to 2017. Literally, there were no Nazis ever present or even welcome at shows." Another user claims that some of the posts weren't from 9 years ago when Malloy was 16, but were posted as recently as a few years back when she was 21. That tweet didn't have any photos, so not sure how accurate that is. However, the tweet also pointed out the fact that at 16, you're old enough to know racism isn't okay. And I'm gonna have to agree on that point there. At 16, you should know being a racist is just, yeah, it's just a no-go. You just don't do that. The tattoo parlor where Malloy's husband, Dan, worked also posted a statement claiming that he has stepped down from his position as co-owner and that the company will, I quote, "continue to support BLM and BIPOC and proactively pursue positive change and encourage others to do the same." They've also made a donation to the Healing Foundation and have cut all affiliations with the Malloys. Neither Lucy nor Dan have publicly commented on the situation since deleting their profiles, likely just keeping a low profile, hoping this will all blow over. Now, I will say, guys, I'm always one to push educating one another and giving the benefit of the doubt. But to post this kind of stuff at 16 years old, I mean, Lucy is, I think, 26 now, so hopefully she has educated herself and genuinely doesn't still believe in the ideologies she was so proud of before. As they say, actions speak louder than words, so we'll see what she does moving forward, but I have a feeling she's likely going to just stay low pro for a while and hope everyone just moves on. As always, guys, I'd love to hear your thoughts on this one, so please drop me some comments down below with your thoughts. For now, let's plot some comments from the video, Top 10 Celebrities That Got Exposed During the Pandemic, Part 2. Sean Gonzalez said, money can't defeat insecurities, and Justin Bieber is definitely an insecure guy. I'm not gonna lie, dude, when I first saw your name, I fully thought it was Gomez, and I was like, yo, this is definitely like Selena Gomez's like older brother just coming at Biebs right now, and then I realized it wasn't, but, yeah, I don't know. I don't know about that. Do you think Bieber's insecure? I mean, I feel like it's easy just to hate him and say yeah, but I don't know, he's a pretty good looking guy. He's got a hell of a career. He's got a wife, which he seems very happy. What's there to be insecure about? Maybe the whole Calvin Klein expanding his size thing. I don't know. Connie Ruelas Avila said, Ed is not a celebrity. Yeah, a lot of you guys got mad at me for including Ed there, but I mean, okay. What is the definition of a celebrity? It's somebody that, you know, is on TV, I guess, and they're well known. That's what Ed is. He's a reality TV celebrity. Like, is Kim Kardashian a celebrity? She's a reality TV star, but she's a celebrity. Is Snooki a celebrity? Is like any of the people from Jersey Shore celebrities? Think about it. The Bachelor, are they celebrities? People get excited when they see them. Why? They're people. Then again, all celebrities are people. Kobe Jones said, quoting me, the last video was popular. Yeah, because we like the female hosts better. She throws mad shade and is hilarious. It's actually really funny that you wrote that, Kobe, because I hosted the last video. So, you can try again, though, if you want. I'll wait. Anyways, guys, that's it for this one. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. You guys have been watching I.O., and we'll see you in the next one.